More than 2.7 million doses of Pfizer's COVID vaccine arrived in the Philippines on Sunday. The jabs were donated by the U.S. government through the vaccine sharing platform COVAX. According to the National Task Force Against COVID-19, 52.1 million Filipinos have been fully vaccinated against the coronavirus, while 3 million booster shots have been administered. The government aims to fully vaccinate 77 million by the first quarter of 2022.
COVID-19 cases in the Philippines nearing the 3 million mark. The nationwide tally hit over 2,965,000 on Sunday after the health department logged an all-time high of 28,707 new infections. The 44% positivity rate is also the highest we've seen since the pandemic began. Metro Manila is still at the center of the possible Omicron-fueled outbreak. But an analyst points out cases in neighboring regions are also nearing record levels.
Marami talaga dun sa mga kaso yung transmission nangyayari sa NCR. But if we're going to look at what's happening now, although nag-simulate din kami for Calabar Zone and Region 3, no, but what's happening now is ang bilis din ng pagkalat sa Region 3 and Region 4A. Kung matatandaan po natin, nalampasan na natin yung peak nung September 11 ng Delta for NCR. And for Region 4A and Region 3, malapit-lapit na po.
The Philippine General Hospital now limiting its admission of non-COVID patients as it grapples with the latest coronavirus surge. PGH spokesman Dr. Jonas Del Rosario said that as of Sunday, they only had 49 free beds left in their COVID ward, while their intensive care unit was already full.
We will only take real emergencies. Tinigil muna po ang pag-admit sa mga elective cases para bumaba yung non-COVID, and then now you can import or reassign some of the non-COVID personnel back to the COVID operations.
PGH is also low on manpower after more than 300 of its medical staff tested positive for COVID-19. Other health workers were also forced to isolate after being tagged as close contacts. To keep the hospital's operations going, PGH has allowed virus-exposed workers to skip quarantine if they are asymptomatic. This directive has angered several groups.
Nakakalungkot po ano at nakakagalit itong ginawa ng Department of Health na issuance nila, kasi tao din kami, mga health workers, hindi kami, pare-pares po tayo lahat at hindi kami immortal. Pwede ka pang makahawa kasi hindi naman guarantee na pag asymptomatic ka, automatic, hindi ka na makakahawa.
Ang mas matimbang po sa amin ay yung makapagbigay ng service sa mga pasyente at hindi tumigil ang operasyon ng ospital. Sa ngayon po ay nasa crisis po tayo eh.
The Philippine Health Department earlier said the quarantine of vaccinated health workers exposed to a probable COVID patient can be waived, while the 10-day isolation period can be shortened to 5 days. COVID-19 strikes the campaigns of several 2022 aspirants. Vice presidential candidate Senator Kiko Pangilinan is amongst the latest to test positive for the disease. This was confirmed by his wife, actress and singer Sharon Puneta, who says Pangilinan has been isolated from the rest of the household. Pangilinan's running mate, Vice President Lenny Robredo, has also announced that several of her employees have contracted the virus. Despite this, Robredo says their services will continue. She also urges the national government to conduct mass testing and to provide incentives to encourage vaccinations instead of threatening the unvaccinated with arrest.
Nakita ko yung statement ng DOH na hindi kailangan ng mass testing. Ako hindi ako sang-ayon doon. Para nga sa akin, Kaeli, 2 years na, dapat napaghandaan na natin ito. Sobrang halaga ng testing kasi ito yung magiging basis kung kailangan mong mag-quarantine.
As for the tandem of Bongbong Marcos and Sara Duterte, their Uniteam headquarters in Mandaluyong City will remain closed for another week. That's after 68 more staff members and volunteers tested positive for COVID on Friday. Meanwhile, Labor leader and presidential aspirant Lodi de Guzman has decided to cancel all of his physical campaign activities and meetings due to the rising number of COVID-19 cases.
At least 15 crew members of a ship docked in Masbate test positive for COVID-19. The vessel came from Pio Duran Port in Albay. A temporary travel suspension for ships to and from Piyuduran Port has been implemented. Close contacts of the patients will also undergo RT-PCR testing Monday.